this is such an exciting album. Okay, fellas, tell me about the first meeting. Smokey.
First of all, I was aware of their music, and I was aware of the fact that they had recorded some Motown songs and some Motown music and some of my songs, and I was very happy about that. And I was hoping to myself that they were as good in person as they were on the records. And they absolutely blew me away. See, they're better. And I really mean that. I don't say that because I don't bite my tongue on music. And I think if I do, then I'm doing someone an injustice. But they came and they sang Ooh Baby Baby for me, a cappella. It is the greatest version. I mean, I'm just sitting there, my mouth was open. And it was so good to know that they are actual singers.
Cue the boys. Come on, give it to
all
me,
right,
fellas.
We'll do a little bit.
I'm crying. Imagined four Aussie boys, white boys from Australia doing that.
Well, I could never imagine four black boys from Brooklyn doing it like that. You know what I mean? They just absolutely, it's so wonderful.
Now, other wonderful people that you've thought of with, Martha Reeves.
We ended up spending the day with Martha, and she actually toured us through the Hitsville, the old studio, which is now the Motown Museum, and which was awesome, you know, seeing the, you know, hearing all the stories that she had from back in the day, and you know, telling us where she stood for a particular song to record it, and we got to sing in the Snake Pit, the original studio, and it was wonderful for us because, I mean, with the past few years we've been doing all this music, but to actually put the physical place to, you know, where it all began was pretty magical.
Mary Wilson.
She lives in Las Vegas, and we went there when she was recording, and she just had the full soul sister going on. Like, she, in the studio, she was so active, and we were blown away, just totally blown away by her sound and just the way she sounds on the record.
Unbelievable.
If you were vice president of the company, I mean, this is just mega stuff coming up to its 50th anniversary. You were quite instrumental in finding or creating Diana Ross.
She had this little unique voice that I felt like was so identifiable. I felt like if she ever got a hit record, that as soon as you heard her voice, you would know that's Diana Ross. And so when they graduated from high school, Barry would not let me record them until they graduated from high school because we already had Stevie. And when Stevie went out on the road, he required tutors and a bunch of extra people because of still being that age where he had to do schoolwork. So when they graduated from high school, I brought them over and I signed them up and I recorded two or three records on them and nothing really happened. And then How Long Goes Your Howling recorded Where Did Our Love Go? And the rest is like history for them.
On a serious note, in the 80s, drugs were an issue. How dangerous, even to this day, and even worse, are they?
They are crippling and devastating. And I had gone to that point where I was totally devastated. And I went and I was prayed for by a minister who is a very good friend of mine. Her name is Pastor Jean Perez. And I didn't know her till that point, but she told me that before I got to her church that evening, that God had told her I was coming. And when I walked in that church, I was an addict, and came out, I was free.
There's a song on the album, Tears of a Clown. Now, you wrote that song, Smokey.
Yes.
How did that happen?
I wanted to write something about the circus that would be warm and touching. So I wrote about Pagliacci, who was the clown. Made everybody happy. He was sad because he didn't have a woman who loved him. So he cried because of that. So that's basically what it's about.
Cue the boy. You've got to do a bit of Tears of the Clown.
Oh, you've never done Tears of the Clown, I could tell.
A smile on my face. It's only there trying to fool the public. But when it comes down to fooling you, now, honey, that's quite a different subject. So let my glad expression give you the wrong impression. Really, I'm sad,
sad, sad, sad,
sad,
sad,
sad,
sad, sad, so bad. I pretend to be dead. Sad, 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 sad.
Now, there's some sad things known to man.
Now my life's complete.
All right.
Are they cool or what? Human Nature's Get Ready is out now. We move on.